Hi, I'm Dr. Padilla, and we're going to continue our series on interactions in Vega-Lite. Previously, we made this interactive visualization where users can highlight different portions of our Gapminder dataset, and they can color those, and the others will be grayed out. Now what we want to do is allow people to select individual regions and just have those color-coded. If you didn't watch the previous video, all we've done so far is we've imported Vega-Lite, imported the dataset, and here is the code, and you'll want to pause the video and copy down this code, or it will also be in the description. Now, there are three steps that we need to take in order to make this interactivity work. The first one is to extract or specify a specific value for the menu. This is essentially a way for us to indicate what we want in our drop-down menu. Then we'll need to add this field specification, and this is going to limit the selection. Right now, everything is selectable, all the data within our plot, and what we'll want to do is specify just what we want to be selectable. We'll limit that. And then the last one is bind. We'll essentially bind that information to the particular widget, which will be our menu. So first, what I actually need to do is to create this specific values that we want for our menu. So what I've done here is I've just created an array and I've indicated all of the different regions here. You can see them all in order like this. Now this is a version where I've just hard coded the regions. You could also extract this from the data set, but this is just as easy. So you'll need to pause the video and copy this over. Okay, now that we have specified the values that we want to include in the menu, then we need to add both the fields and we need to bind it. So for fields, we'll just add that and I'll fill it in a second, and then bind. And we need to make sure have that closed out properly. So for fields, what I want to do is I want to limit the selection to the region as we've specified here. And for bind, what I want to do is bind it to a menu, and a menu is a dropdown. So we'll do vl.menu and we'll bind the region to that as well. Run that. Oh, looks like I'm getting an error. Oh yes. In the previous version, we had interval, but we actually need to change this to point to make that work. There we go. So right now what we have going on is it created this dropdown right here, and we can select now the different regions, which is pretty cool. And notice it's color coding those. It's making them colored or gray scale based on how we selected them. Now, right now it says this name region. We can actually change that to be selection, and it will populate here. Selection underscore region. Another thing we can add to it that isn't necessarily required but is quite useful is define the initial value, which we'd specify here, and we can set this to region and specify this region, and then we can indicate the order. So if we enter 0, it'll be the first one as the default here. Now notice this default setting, or 2, for example, to be the second one in the order. And essentially all that really did was to have something pre-selected, which can be quite useful if you want to tell a story, possibly where you want one of these selected as the default. The last thing I'll do in terms of modifying this is we can change this from a menu to a radio button. And now we have these different button selection options. Now, in terms of our visual analytics process, this was fun. It's fun to add interactivity, but it hasn't really helped us in terms of gaining insights about this data set. In particular, notice that there's all of this white space over here. It's actually quite hard to figure out what values are over here, what countries, for example, have these very high incomes because the dots are quite small. And what we've done so far has not really helped us interpret this portion of the data. So what we'll do in the next video is to look at both navigation that allows us to pan and zoom into areas of the data and to investigate certain data points more specifically.